Hi guys, welcome to another hands-on lesson. In this one, we're going to configure cross-account access to Amazon S3. This is what we're going to do. So it's very similar to what we saw in the theory in the last lesson. It's the other way around. So we're going from account A to account B in this case, or DCT management to DCT production. So consider this to be account A and this to be account B. Now we're going to create a user called Jack. He's going to have an identity-based policy. He's going to assume a role in DCT production with an external ID. And that role will have a trust policy and a permissions policy to allow him to access an S3 bucket. So that's what it looks like. And we've got a bit of code to use. You'll find in the course download, there's a few files. Now you'll find them in code, cross account access. We've got commands.sh, which is a list of CLI commands. So we're basically going to do pretty much everything in account A, so DCT management, using the CLI. Then there's a JSON file, which is a policy document. This is for Jack, the user we're going to create, and it gives him the ability to list roles and to assume a role. Then we've got a trust policy for account B. And this is the trust policy that's going to allow our user in account A to be able to access and assume the role in account B. So we need commands.sh first. Now what you'll need to do ahead of time, it's probably easier to do it ahead of time. So what you'll need to do is go and find your account numbers for account A and account B. And you need to replace account A ID here with the account ID from account A. And then you've got account B ID here. You'll need to replace that as well. So I've just gone ahead and done that. So I've got my account IDs ready. So we can go over to a console and start running these commands. So let's copy the first command here. And this is simply to create the user Jack. So I'm just going to paste that in and that's successful. So we now have a user called Jack. The next command is going to create a policy. Now for this particular command, we need access to this file. So you'll want to change your command line to make sure that you're in the directory where you have this file, jack-s3.json. So I'm going to change directory, and then I'm going to paste in this command, hit enter, and that's been created. So we can see that that has been created. Let's just quit out of there, come back, and let's get our next command. So this one is going to attach the user policy to the username Jack, and this is the policy ARN. So this is where we need to make sure that the ARN is correct. So it should be Jack-S3 as long as you've used Jack-S3 here. So let's head back to the command line, run that command, and that looks good. Let's come back again. And what we can do now is just check that that's worked, because sometimes you can't really see very well. So you want to be sure. So this one is going to list the policies that are attached to Jack. So let's run the command. And there we go. We can see that there's a policy name, Jack-S3, and we can see the ARN. So that's definitely worked. Let's come back again. And now we're going to create access keys for Jack. So let's just run this command. And this is going to create an access key and a secret access key. So we get the access key ID and the secret access key. So what you'll need to do is copy these values and save them somewhere. I'm simply going to add mine at the bottom of the file. So I've got those two stored. And now we're going to run AWS configure. Now we've already run AWS configure and we've stored some credentials for our main account. So now we're using the --- profile, which means we can have a separate profile which we can run any commands we want then as Jack. So we're storing additional credentials. So we come back. Let's run this command. It's going to ask for the access key ID. I've pasted that in, and then the secret access key, and then the default region name. I'm going to use AP Southeast 2 because I'm in Australia. And then let's hit enter. Now it doesn't really matter what region name you place in there. For this particular exercise, we're working with S3 and IAM, and they're both global services. I now want to check. I'm going to run this command. And what it does is it shows the identity that's being used to execute commands without a profile. So without specifying --- profile Jack. So let's run this command. So we can see in this case, if we just run a command without specifying a profile, we're running it as my user account, and that's in the DCT management, so account A. What we need to do now is actually assume the role, but we haven't created the role yet. So what we need to do is we're going to log in as our management account to our main account, so DCT management for me, and then we're going to switch roles to our second account, and we're going to create the new role there. I'm logged into my main account, so what I'm going to do is switch roles using this organization account access role. We're going to go to roles, create role, and this is where we need to specify the trust relationship. In this case, we're going to choose another AWS account, and we need to specify the account ID of account A, so that for me that's DCT-management, the main account where we have most of our IAM identities. So I'm going to paste that in, and in this case we want to require an external ID, and you see it says this is a best practice when a third party will assume this role, and we're going to put in an external ID. Now I've already got the external ID in the command line here, so what I'm going to do is literally just copy this and then paste this in. So we got the external ID, and note that you can also enable multi-factor authentication, but we won't do that for now. Let's click on next, and now we need to specify the permissions that we want for this role. So perhaps for this one, we'll just search for S3, and then we'll provide S3 full access. We're going to click on next. We don't need any tags, and the role name, for me, it's going to be cross account S3 access with hyphens in the middle. And you do need to make sure that you keep this the same as the name you're going to use in the code when you try to assume the role. So that's the one I'm using. You can use that one as well. Let's choose create role. And that's all ready now. So let's just go in and have a look. So let's go and have a look at the trust relationship. Click on edit. And let's just have a look at this. Now, this is the same code you saw in the file that I gave you as part of the course download, but this is actually populated for you. So we did it through the GUI. It's quite simple. Now, as you can see, the ARN here has the account number colon root. That doesn't mean the root account. It actually means all accounts. So anybody in this account is able to assume this role on the condition that they know this external ID, and that must be supplied in the assume role API call. So let's just cancel out of there. We've got the trust relationship and we've got the permissions set up correctly, so we should be able to assume our role. Back in Visual Studio Code, we're going to copy this entire command line. So note that this is going to run SDS assume role with the profile Jack, the role ARN, so Jack is actually going to assume the role. The role ARN is cross account S3 access, and then the session name here is AWS CLI-session, and then we have an external ID. So that's the external ID that we shared with our second account. So let's go and run this command. The command has run successfully, and we've got a few pieces of information that we need. Firstly, we got the access key ID. We want to copy this access key ID from inside the inverted commas. Come back, and we're going to paste it here. So we're going to paste it on this export command where we have access AWS access key ID equals, and then that's where we put in the access key. Come back, do the same for the secret access key. We're going to paste that in the next line so we can remove everything after the equals and then paste this in. And then lastly, we need all of this great big block of code from there to there. So copy the entire session token. Note that there's also an expiration here as well. So that tells you when this information is going to expire. And it's usually a couple of hours. So let's come back and we'll replace the role session token. So now we've got some information here for our next commands. And what these commands are going to do is they're going to set environment variables on our command line that include the access key ID, the secret access key, and the session token. So let's run each of these one after the other. That's one. Let's copy the next one, paste that in, hit enter, and then come back for the last command, and we're going to paste that in. So we've now set the environment variables. That means that if we run AWS commands from the CLI, without specifying a profile, we should now be using the assumed role, because it's going to, by default, use the access key ID, secret access key, and session token here. And these are the assumed roles information. So instead of using my account, Neil, it should use this information. And we can test that now. So we're going to run the AWS STS get caller identity again. Remember, last time this showed that we were running commands as my account in the DCT management account. So let's run this command, and we can see in this case, we're running it as the assumed role in the second account. That's the cross account S3 access role with the AWS CLI session. So that shows us that we're now running our commands on the CLI with an assumed role. So we should now be able to run S3 commands quite easily. Now you can always change the name of your bucket. I'm just using something here that should be unique. Let's come back. If we run AWS S3 LS, we should be able to see the buckets that we created earlier in the course in that second account. And I can create a new bucket as well quite easily. View the two buckets that we now have in the account. That's really it for this lab. I hope you enjoyed that. I really wanted to show you a bit more of the command line, as well as showing you how to assume a role for a specific use case. Now, in order to clean this up, you can always go ahead and delete that bucket if you like. I'm just going to delete it here. And that's gone. And then you might want to unset. So this is to remove those environment variables from your CLI. And that just means that you're now going to run any commands back as your main account. So my account is the Neil account in the DCT management account. So that's it for this lesson. And in the next lesson, we're going to look at a use case for using IAM roles with EC2. And I would advise you to leave this configuration in place, the rest of it, for instance, the Jack user account, because we're going to use Jack again.